How dare they?
Construction finished on schedule.
The investigating crew of the USS Cerritos did not disappoint in their search for Kurgan artifacts. I just see Boimler running around some artifacts and breaking stuff while the others are doing whatever they do. Spy in our systems, spy their systems even harder. Searching through the ruins of Otana 2, one of our xenoarchaeologists discovered an intact 3rd dynasty Kurlan Nyskos. Ah, yeah, okay. Ceramic figurine statue is over 12,000 years old and incredibly rare. Don't give that thing Boimler! You will break it. Research and unity. Oh, look at that. Energy credits. I don't need energy credits. Research and unity. Hey, that's nice. Yeah, we're going down with research. 4,500, so we need that. Easy. Go for the counter-espionage, please. Les.
Incoming transmission.
From what?
We will do our best to understand you.
Betazoid, offer migration treaty. Thank you! They offered it themselves! Enter into migration treaty with the civilization. Our population will be able to freely migrate between both empires. Heck yeah. And the Andor starbase is complete. Docked ship upkeep. Resource silo. Aim assistance. Shield. Warp collection transponders. Collection range. What does that mean? Warp collection. Relocation center. What does that even do? Space Station 7 or Deep Space 3? Interesting. It's the collection range from trade income. But there isn't really nothing around it. Yeah, I think the same. I think the same. We now have a trade route with Andor, which is really nice. Vulcan, Sol, Andor. Then we need Risa too, but later.
We have surveyed a new star system.
That looks funny. A hermetically sealed biopod has been located. Otana is really nice. Silent alarm in Seoul. Yeah, I know. Spy ship is still moving. Construction ship is not doing anything because... Yeah. If I gain this... 103. Are they able to get... to this system if I get this system? What's that? First contact event. Carry out a mission. Intel set to 20. Unity gained. Or I can do a mission or I can do celebration. Let's celebrate it. First contact with the Kesprit. Kesprit. Wait, Kesprit, isn't that where? Kesprit. Oh. Not Kesprit. Kesprit. Intelligent and warp-capable species native to the planet Kesprit 3. They were divided into two rivaling countries known as the Kes and the Prit. Due to the long conflict between the two nations, both states have developed a strong sense of paranoia and xenophobia. There were virtually no intergovernmental communications, not even in an emergency capacity, since the late 23rd century. Okay, I cannot remember that that episode. I researched solar cells that give 10 energy each and built 60 stations for energy production. Game instant crashed when I clicked show trade routes. Were you followed? No. Okay, good. One cannot be too careful these days with those treacherous Prit spies. There you go. We have attached the Kes Alliance, and I represent Prime Minister Sarin, leader of all Kes. While our civilization is going through a period of turmoil, I am certain that with your help, we will be able to confront these dangerous rebels and bring peace to our systems. Yeah, there was a character called Kes, but nothing to do with those Kes people. These are the Kes people. Do you remember that episode with those? There was only one episode. TNG episode attached. Wait. Season 7, episode 8. In the last season. I cannot remember that. I forgot. Is this Star Trek, but the Federation has a competent military command and control? Thank you. Yes. Yeah, right? This is like, sometimes there are episodes that are just so unimportant that you just forget everything. I don't know. Intercoms are so impersonal. Whatever. I guess. Where are they? There. Okay, funny. First contact finished. What do you want? Can now use the territorial reparations. Kesprit Republic.
Which side do you stand with, Kes or Prit? Answer carefully.
How good are you? Kesprit, which one is Kesprit? Kesprit. Relative power. Declare war. I will declare war once we have the Enterprise. Stop designing your ships to be multi-role and min-max, fellas. Yeah, well. Fleet can be upgraded. Will be upgraded for minus 30. The hermetically sealed bioport located in a dry groundwater pocket on Otana has been found intact. X-ray scans detect that the tinted glass capsule have identified that it contains a preserved biome. no doubt belonging to this lifeless planet. Curiously, it appears that the biome itself is alive and sentient, directing electrical signals at our communication devices in an attempt to establish first contact with the crew of the USS Cerritos. Our astonished xenoecologists confirm that opening the capsule would restore a powerful entity in the form of a living biome and see a habitable ecosystem flourish once again. Restoring the planet's ecosystem provides us with a new colonizable world. Send the pod to our labs. We should transfer it home to enrich the studies of our xenoecologists in training. Technology gained, terraforming. What? I can gain terraforming. This is huge. The Federation way of doing things would be opening the biopod and having a new habitable world, but I like technology. I like. We need one more first contact and then we are good here. And then at some point we can go Section 31 if we want. Stop hitting yourself, Casus Belli.
Research modeled. New technology has passed testing protocol.
Nice. Unlocks building world capital. Whoa. Housing 8, amenities 8, building slots 3, civil servant jobs, security officer, counselor, science director, civil servants produce unity, wait, base production is 3 officers, 13 food, 21 research, 46 unity, amenities, stability, minus crime, plus 2, whatever this is, weapons. And it really doesn't cost that much. What the heck? Courts of Judgment. Security officer reduce crime and produce officers. Spawn defensive defensive armies. Crazy. Hey, research speed plus 5%. That sounds really nice.
70. Is continuing duty as Lieutenant Junior Grade, 19 month on duty cap, resistant is futile.
Resistance is futile. Diddy, thank you so much for the tier 2 sub. Thank you very, very much. Thank you for the support. Very, very much appreciated. Nice. I need an answer from Stellaris veterans. Is it better to block the Cardassians from gaining like another settlement behind me, or is it better to just grab a system that is actually beneficial to me and not like just blocking the enemy? Because I feel like I could rather than take this here, I could take, for example, Zeta Dory and have, like, more out of the system than here. You know. Oh, then it is 2, 2, 1, 3. That is just plus 2. Plus 1 energy and 3 trade value. And this would be... Wait, this is 1, 1, 1, and 3. And this is...
Captain, Rasu. Got promoted to Lieutenant Junior Grade. Hello, Darth Captain Collins.
Thank you. Congratulations, Lieutenant Junior Grade. Thank you, Russia, for the Prime. Very much appreciated. Blocking is a good choice. As someone familiar to Star Eater should bully the Cardassians. They're gonna jump behind you anyway, since the way warp and range works in this. I have no idea what's going on, but grabbing land is not super important unless it's a good chokehold. Yeah, because then they can't, like, they would need to get around this here, and they can't just... But look at the... If I apply this range to Ilvora... Wait, I need to do that with my fingers. Or can I use this here, maybe? Yeah, almost. If I apply that to Ilvora, that means maximum what they could do at the moment is like Valo. If I get Valo from here to here, that means this warp range would not be enough to get past this. At the moment, they could go from here to here with their construction ship. I also don't know if they have any upgrades or whatsoever to make them better. But if I just take my range and apply it onto their planet, that means the only planet they can reach is Valo. And if I block Valo, they cannot sneak behind me and like get Mazaf or Taz. That's impossible for them. I think that's good. I should do that. Yeah. They can build behind you. They will, and it will be... Yeah, it will be really bad later on. Where's the circle when you need one? So, wait. Oh, that doesn't work. Snippy. Ooh! Oh, look at that! So, from here to... Oh, how do you... Hello? How do you... It's a protect... I mean, it almost works. It's a little bit more than this, right? Oh, whoa. What's that? No. Okay. Ruler. From here to here, what is this? How can I see? Oh my god. How can I see this? How do you do this? Damn it. How do you change that? Heck. Ah, mouse wheel, there you go. Okay, so I'm from here to here, right? If I take that thing and put it there and then mouse wheel it. Whew, nice, cool. Look, that means they cannot get it. It's a little bit outside of their reach. You see that? So that's a little bit outside of their reach. Yeah. Nice. There, science in progress. Yes.
We have surveyed a new star system.
It's Lara. And what does it have? Nothing. 10 minutes later, the AI takes it anyway because the AI cheats. Exactly. Let me go there already and get some intel on this system. Oh yeah, I want to keep it. Oh. Party time! After 4 days of celebration on Ryza, I am ready to come home. The settlers of Ryza know how to throw a party. such a meme. I barely remember it. There were conventions, street fairs, delicious food, music, dancing, and not much downtime though. To be completely honest, my head friggin' hurts. These subspace frequencies are not helping. Some vacations we require another vacation. That's exactly what I always say at work. Sorry about the headache. Gnarla gains the party animal traits, granting the planetary build speed and unity from jobs. Oh my god. Okay. Close file. 80 influence. Nothing further to report. No, I'm gaining influence. Oh my god, 80 influence. That's a lot. Bam. Awesome. Build starbase.
Difficult terrain cleared by our planetary engineers.
What? Oh, cool. Great. Didn't that give me 500 alloys? Wait a second. Wait for the next month. I think I got 500 alloys. Let's see. No, I didn't. Okay, interesting. Missing technology. Increases amenities and immigration pool. Festivals modifier added for 10 years, giving the following effects. Amenities plus 25%, immigration pool plus 25%. Festivals on Ryza? Heck yeah! did you factor the possibility that they may have better range? No, I did not. That's what I said. I have no idea if they do or not. What is this? Kess? Science ship? I am. That's what I said. I have no idea if they have better range. If they have like some kind of advanced tech or whatsoever. The governorship doing? You're not doing anything. Wait, I was right at the moment. 54%. Yeah, that's what I thought. Percent. Oh wow. Wait, what the heck? Plus 2% per governor level. Oh, that's another 10%. A planet with high planet stability will have increased resource production, while a planet with low stability will suffer important penalties. But the thing is, we do not have aligned people. That's the thing, you know? Indoctrinate pops. Let's do this.
Construction finished on schedule.
Nice. Good. Automatic counter, counter stuff. Wait, you're done with Otana? Why is my first fleet there? First fleet of the Vulcan. What was that? Ving.
We have surveyed a new star system.
Aldara. You know what? It would be way more beneficial.
Construction finished on schedule.
It would be way better if
we have surveyed a new star system.
First contact. New civilization had at least one station in the system. What is this? That looks nice. Right. You have an envoy? Yes. That should be the next first contact thing. And then we can go down here. Establish trade routes. Trade value, trade annex built in star bases. Do we need that many star bases? I cannot build trade annexes there. So I think we need to build more star bases. Starport. Star base. Trade annex. I cannot build a trade annex. It's weird. What do you want? Scientist. Okay, great. Dismantle. Should actually fight the Nausicaans. No Ferengis in this? Not yet. I don't know. Do you know where the Ferengi systems are? Maybe we'll find the Ferengis if I know where their systems are.
We will do our best to understand you.
Propose integration process. Yay!
Construction finished on schedule.
Has to begin the integration process to assimilate the Betazoid houses. If they accept, we can start the integration process. We'll also gain their unique civic, moving us closer to diplomatic victory. Let's see if that works. The Endor Starbase. Here. Above Cardassians. Hey Lando, thank you very much for following. Here somewhere. Okay, maybe we can find them. I think Ferengis should be in the game. If you ask me. They should really be in the game. Ren is gone. See you later. I think they should be in. Integration process started.
We will do our best to understand you.
We accept. Has to begin the integration process to assimilate the Betazoid. Haha! Let's assimilate them. If they accept, we can start process diplo action. Okay.
We will do our best to understand you.
Start integration process. Oh, damn it. Take her. Integration. How long does that take? From ideology? From technology? From stability? Monthly progress 1. 116 months. What? Okay, well, at least we started. Is there a terraform thing? Isn't there like, wait, there was something about terraforming. Grow the Federation. Deep Space Nine! The Inevitable. Bajoran membership. Liberate the oppressed. Grow the Federation. Minor powers assimilated. Form commercial pact. Form research agreement. Can I not do that with some...
We will respect your privacy.
Like, those? No? Those?
Which side do you stand with, Kes or Prit? Answer carefully.
I don't know. Requires positive relations. What are our relations? How can I see that? Current intel. Relations. We currently have terrible relations, plus 12. How is the democracy like doing stuff with the Romulans? I don't understand. Oh, and I knew it. We have unemployment. Yeah. We get unemployment on Earth. Trade value, amenities, housing. Housing looks good. Maybe we can build something. Starfleet Academy can be replaced, huh? Military base. Monument. Unity and trade value. I think we go industrial. Let's go industrial. Oh, there's really nothing else with deuterium. deuterium. Intrepid will be ready in 11 months.
We have surveyed a new star system.
Which one? Durad. It's up there, right? Oh yeah. Finalize. Oh! There we go! The Ferengi! Who asked? Nibom! There you go! We got them! Relations established with the Ferengi Shady Emporium. What's a Shady Emporium?
Happy guy. Oh, just a happy guy. Oh, just a look at
that.
A happy dog.
Hey, Manadel, good morning. Visual contact has been established with the Ferengi Shady Emporium from Durad. Communication with these people has shown them to hold a unique set of skills, unlike any other civilization. They have already made a name for themselves in this galaxy. All right. There you go. That's the Ferengis. Is that now... Does that mean we're... Nah, we're still not ready with first contact.
We have surveyed a new star system.
Oh, wow, 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 wow. We have surveyed everything. Avon and Dultizi and Durin, we have surveyed all of that. Only one. It's okay. Three deuterium. Is that worth it? I don't know. But it is. It would give us another. It would give us some range down here. That tree is the same as Heart of Iron. Which tree? I feel like we should now finally start, like, maybe fighting something, but...
Eldor Joy!
We still have terrible relations. Why that? Whoa, 6,000. To a maximum of 100 tense relations. Okay. Zorik Mothrin. Class L planet. 18. Maybe you want to get like a new planet. 18 is not bad. Drygo. Drygo. Drygo 4. Wait, this is... The heck? Okay, I found the first major flaw. Drygo is... The planet was located 3.2 light years away from Cardassian space in the Cardassian sector of the Alpha Quadrant. First of all, this is not in the Alpha Quadrant, this is in the Beta Quadrant. Because here's like the... Like, Sol is like the... No, the border. This is in the Beta Quadrant. This is the Alpha Quadrant. Is that the Alpha Quadrant? Is that the Beta Quadrant? Hey, wait, which quadrant is that? Yeah, Beta Quadrant. Knew it. Beta Quadrant. And it's not in the Cardassian sector. Ah, major flaw. The planet was considered by Dr. Beverly Crusher and Commander Data as a possible home for the Borallans, following Dr. Nikolai Rozhenko's unauthorized transport of the group aboard the USS Enterprise D. Season 7, episode 13? What? Okay. Wow. Oh god. This is huge! Okay. This is actually huge. Crystal. Oh, Earth. Pandoria. Nausicaa. Nausicaa should be around here. But Nausicaa is in here. I guess that's Nausicaa. How is it so bad? Why did they change it so much? Oh, and Landersan, sorry for the timeout. Was like because only crew members are allowed to post links, but I can see it anyways.
We have surveyed a new star system.
But yeah, if we take a look at the map... Crazy. Look how big this is. Oh my god. Oops. Hello? There you go. Look, there's Nausicaa right there. This here is Nausicaa, and in our map, it's somewhere far
Discovery
there.
Discovery logged.
Where the Cardassian Union should be. There's Risa. Suliban. Beta Z? Okay, that's like accurate almost. But this here is completely not accurate.
Research modeled.
Drygo. There's Drygo. Found it. Right there. You see it? There. That mouse is pointy. This is the official Star Trek charts map as well. Oh, wow. Okay. Subspace fractures. What is Data doing there? A thorough magnetic scan of Zorik has revealed subspace fractures created by a Polaric explosion. Yeah, research. Oh, wait.
New technology has passed testing
research
protocols.
Complexes. Plasma gun. Superheated plasma from the warp core is coalesced in a directional beam and then fired towards enemy vessels. Interesting. Unlocks component sensors will reveal the details of any systems and fleets within their range. Long-range scanners. Sensors. Precise information on enemy movements can be worth more than entire fleets. Ship detection range. Sensor range. Energy from mining stations. No, I think that's a good one. Sensors. Alright, and...
New technology has passed testing protocols.
Intrepid class warships. Whoop whoop. Capable of sending heavy bombardments to enemy fleets and planets. Nice. Phase payloads. Fast moving missile with a powerful payload. The explosion releases enough energy to reduce vessels to smithereens. Excuse me? Medium phase payloads. Hmm. Starbase building. Ice mining station. Celestial holo planning. Build cost, district cost. I like that. Base payloads. Materials. Do we have someone for materials? Yeah, I know. Commanding USS Mikita. Not really. Okay, well then. We can now build ships! Ship designer! Woo! Nice! Yay! Woo! Give us a new one. Intrepid. Wait, was that interceptor, escort, or warbird? Warbird? Hey, Ian? Lane? Morning. Welcome aboard. Ship fire rate, ship evasion. Ship fire rate, ship hit points. Ship fire rate, sublight speed. What are you using at the moment? Interceptor. Stay information protecting the fleet while targeting medium ships. Stay information protecting the fleet while targeting smaller ships. Get close to the enemy and target smaller ships. Shield hit points. 15%. Okay. Small plasma charge. I want to grab the payload thing, but I don't know. At the moment, I think I'm just going for phaser banks. Burst phaser changing anything? Yeah, no, making it worse. Intrepid. What are we going to call that? Let's go... Which country do we take for Intrepid? Intrepid. Resolute Design. What? Resolute? No. Let's see here. Ooh, cool. Let's take this one. Oh, now let's say something with I. City with I. A city with I. Dun, 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 dun. It's a shame that the main enterprise line classes are missing.
Oh.
Yeah, because it's like they went for only that that one iconic ship and not all of them. Like not having an entire line of them. Yeah. Ippo. Ippo. How about here? Oh, not that easy to find something with an I. Ippo sounds nice, but I don't want to take an American city. I know Indianapolis or something, but too easy. Ipoh. It's a Malaysian town. Ipoh. Ipho. Ipoh. Intrepid class Ipoh design. It's a Malaysian town. Can we build? How much does that take? Ship size 3. Two of them. And then we're going to remove wait, fleet manager. First God, how do you send them over again? How do you send them over again? Hey, Wookie, good morning. Transfer all ships. Transfer ships. Ah, there you go. The Gallico design, right? Wait. I'm pretty confused, but okay. We're building two Intrepid classes, the six fleets, six ship size. Oh my god. Hey Sean! Glad to see you playing this game because I'm absolutely overwhelmed by it as I never played Stellaris before. Oh wow, but then it could be a really good game for you. Uh-oh. Mysterious structure. Various travelers have reported a sighting of a gigantic cubic structure moving through space. No! Similar to the one we encountered many years ago, it is still unclear whether this is simply an artificial structure or something more sinister. Tracking it down would require the completion of the delicate structural integrity scan project. Actually, I'm hating it right now. What? It annoys me that there's no played guide with this game. Wookie, please tell me what you struggle with because I'm doing tutorials for this game right now. I already have two tutorials up, one for governors, ships, and spy ships, and the other one for building ships and using officers. That would be great. Just tell me all your struggles. I'm in the process of doing tutorials for it. Make this investigation our top priority. Investigative zeal modifier added. Giving the following effect, sublight speed plus 5%, minus 500, 40 unity begins the mysterious structure event chain. Oh god, what do I need unity for again? That was something that where I needed 50 unity. Oh yeah, I needed 50 unity for another governor. That's good. That's a good way to do this, Lando.
Mission log updated.
Okay, wait. Mission log updated, I know, but... But... I should also... Like, oh my god, you see that? The Klingons want to take this here down there. I would actually like to go for Drygo. Drygo 4. I would like to go for another planet, but... Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it. We have unemployment on Vulcan. They produce trade goods here. On the other hand, I could build something that makes Vulcan better. I could, for example, I don't know, forges for alloys.
Construction in progress.
Risa's looking good, that's looking good. Andoria needs another thingy. 14, 22, that's already maximum. That's right, yeah. Hey, well, for starters, how the heck are you generating so much power? Trading is a lot. Trading is really a lot. How to get... I would say how to get resources. Or base resources. Basic resources. Power and food are always in the negative for me, no matter how much power I generate. Do you see, you can go on one of those things and see where this is all coming from, where it's consumed or whatsoever. So for example, you see that jobs and trade is actually making a lot. So trade is being produced by star bases. So you need a star base in order to trade. And then you go into your star base, and you can see trade routes. And trade is actually giving you energy credits. Trade and use trade. Don't need that. Trade is giving you a lot. Then jobs, of course. Like, you have different... You have different planets that do different amount of energy per job. You see that Earth, for example, has a base job production of 17. Well, then Andoria has got a base job production of 22. So you want to have the energy districts on the planets that have very high base production being built there. Instead of somewhere else. So you don't need planets to do everything. So you don't need every single planet provide for itself. It is okay to have like specialized planets, like one for food, one for energy, and play out their best cards. That's one of them. Is there a way to influence what trade generates? Having more stations, of course, and then your planet is also building trade value. You gain trade value in city districts, you gain trade value in industrial districts, you have buildings that produce trade value, like this one here from Boyer, for example, a commodity zone. And that way you can increase the trade value of your planet and of your trade route in total. Base production, what was the job actually outputs? No, it's like, yeah, exactly. It's like, what does the job do on this specific planet? On this here, it does 22. If I go on Vulcan, it only does 14. So one population, which is producing energy on Andoria, is way more worth than one population producing energy on Vulcan. So that's why you, on Vulcan, for example, I go for food, because here in this case it also produces trade and food, which it doesn't do on Andoria. On Andoria you only have 14 food without the trade. Earth would be even better with food 17, so that way that one population is doing more for food. So you want to specialize a little bit and distribute the jobs around your systems. Do it like they do on the Discovery. We're building workplaces and not having the pops to run them, are you? Thank you, even if I missed all of that. I'm sorry. But the next... I just wanted to emphasize that every single planet has got a different base production of every single one of those base materials. And you want to have specialized planets to have the best for your population that you're using. And what you also need to keep in mind that it only works if your jobs are actually, you know, occupied. So you will not gain any energy, for example, if you don't have like technicians working on it, for example. So you also need like technicians working on it, otherwise your total job production is lower. You can't just spam that stuff and think that it will increase your energy production. You also need the population to, you know, work in these jobs to actually gain that resource. The problem is with population growth. Yeah, that's why you need to scale very slow at the start. Hey Parker, thank you so much for following. You want to scale slowly at the start because you will need to look for the population always being employed. And if you see this here, for example, this bag, this red bag, that means you have unemployment on your planet. That means you can send your people to new jobs if you build something immediately. That way you ensure that you're always gaining the maximum you can. Klingons have a crappy population growth and you only randomly get tech research instances. Oh yeah, okay. You can also search for planets that do have like population growth modifiers, like for example Ryza in my case here has got a population modifier, pop growth speed plus 10%, as you see, top left corner. Weather control. Festivals are going on. Pop indoctrination. Nice. Unloyal? Wait, what? Why are they unloyal? Okay, well, whatever.